All right, so the PlayStation 5 has pretty much held every PlayStation-centric content creator on hold. When I tell you this system is amazing and we're playing it, we're legit playing it. That's why a lot of our channels have either gone dark or we're just being quiet in general. So anyway, sorry about that here on the channel. I got to make that public announcement because I know a lot of people are like, where the hell is BitCloud? He hasn't covered anything. Well, there you guys go. But I also, in my time away from this channel, I've been talking with our first ever sponsor of this particular channel himself, and he's actually let's say he's lent us his expertise, and you're going to see some insane changes to this platform that have blown me away, that's for sure. So shout out to him, he knows who he is. I'm gonna announce all that when we get into these changes when it happens. Okay, anyway, what am I saying? Why am I rambling at this point? Well, it is definitely good to be back on this microphone, that's for one. It's good to be back here. So going back to last year, I did a video, and ironically, this is when we rebranded the channel to BitCloud Gaming. I did a video which ended up being my most highest rated video on this channel in general. It was talking about God of War, and of course, it was talking about a PS5 Pro in its actual context as well. That video, ironically, ended up being true. As you guys already know, God of War was pretty much shown, or, it was pretty much announced, sorry, at, Sony's last show. Now, again, PS5 Pro, this is definitely looking to be more unlikely a thing. As you guys already know, PS4 Pro, Xbox One X, those pretty much did what they needed to do at the time. Those prolonged those generations for about a year until we got into the PS5 and Series X. But as you guys already know, they weren't really that substantial of an insane upgrade, right? They just weren't over the top. They didn't really do XYZ with those systems. They were either there to correct a few issues and that's it. Others were trying to pursue 4K, but you know how that turned out. The PlayStation 5 Pro, however, or in this particular case, Sony's looking to make a scalable PlayStation 5 Pro, which will have two GPUs implemented into the actual system. This is a big deal for the actual system itself, as you guys see on the screen here. And what Sony's planning to do with this, again, this is going to be like a counterattack, quote unquote. This is what they're saying here in the actual article. It's a counterattack. Now, I don't believe it's going to be, quote unquote, a counterattack. And the reason why I don't think it's a counterattack is because I see Microsoft doing the exact same thing. And you got to think about this for the long-term use as well. By the time we see a PlayStation 5 Pro, it's going to be later in this generation where games in general, what we're seeing, they're going to get all the resources out of the box. They're going to be maxed out. We're going to see pretty much the highest potential for both PlayStation 5 and Series X at that time. And then you're going to see PS5 Pro and Xbox Series XL, right? Let's call it that, Series XL, right? You're going to see all that stuff later down the road. Now, I will read this patent though, because it's definitely interesting read, because they talk about portable devices. And you guys remember we talked about PlayStation, we talked about PSP portable, or it was like 5G portable device. They talked about that also in this actual article. So anyway, let's go ahead and get into it. PS5 Pro with two graphics cards is the death blow Xbox Series X didn't prepare for. That's what according to T3. Anyway, let's go ahead and put this on the screen. Let's go ahead and read this. And I quote, "Just as the dust has begun to settle on the PS5 and Xbox Series X console launches, with the Microsoft flagship officially crowned the most powerful video games console on Earth, comes what could be our very first hint at Sony's incoming PS5 Pro counterattack. That's because in an official Sony Interactive Entertainment patent published this year, the console maker describes a new game console that comes with not just one graphics card, but two. The patent describes a scalable game console where a second GPU is coupled with the first GPU, and that the system is for home console and cloud gaming usage." Now, let me stop there for a second. Cloud gaming, what did we say before when we talked about legacy back and patent, a few other things, right? Remember how they were showing off this patent? Let's put it on the screen for you guys. When they were talking about the cloud and using that to give you back and pat with the legacy titles and stuff like that, this actually could be a thing going into what they're doing, as they're talking about cloud gaming usage as well out of this box. And keep in mind, more likely, there's probably going to be two SKUs of this unit. I don't see why they wouldn't have two SKUs of this, where they'll have the digital version and, of course, the physical. You know, why not? You know, why not have both? So I think they will do that to offer a cheaper option as well. But yeah, pretty interesting, to say the least. Let me know what you guys think about that in the comments below, okay? But anyway, they continue. To us here at T3, that suggests a next-gen PlayStation console, most likely a new PS5 Pro flagship, supercharged with two graphics cards instead of just one. These would both come in the APU, accelerated processing format, that the PlayStation 5's SoC do, with two custom-made AMD APUs working together to deliver enhanced gaming performance and cloud streaming. They go and continue. The official Sony patent notes that plural SoCs may be used to provide a high-end version of the console with greater processing and storage capability, while the high-end system can also contain more memory such as random access memory and other features, and may also be used for cloud-optimized version using the same game console chip with more performance. And with the PlayStation 5 console only marginally weaker on paper than the Xbox Series X, a new PS5 Pro console that comes with two APUs rather than one, improving local gaming performance as well as cloud gaming, would be no doubt the Xbox Series X as king of the next-gen consoles death blow. The cloud gaming part of the patent is particularly interesting too, as it seems to suggest that this technology could not just find itself in a new flagship PS5 Pro console, but also in more streamlined cloud-based hardware too, as, okay, so let me stop there again. Again, they're hinting at what we talked about earlier with the back and pat and stuff like that. But anyway, continue. An upgraded PS5 Digital Edition seems a smart bet as to the much-rumored PSP 5G. And simply put, the other big question this patent raises is that if this technology does lead to a PS5 Pro console, is Microsoft prepared? Right now, Microsoft is still nursing its wounds from the last-gen console war, where it was firmly beaten by Sony. So without facing down any new hardware from Sony with something as big, if not better, it will leave itself exposed to a second straight console gen defeat. And that's basically what they say right there. Now, they did answer one particular question, and it says, will we see a PS5 Pro anytime soon? And they said, absolutely not. We imagined we'll get at least two straight years of the PS5 before we see anything at all. Now, honestly, guys, 2 years is kind of pushing it. 2 years for a PS5 Pro, I highly doubt you'll see a PS5 Pro in 2 years. What you'll see is, again, like I said before, it's going to happen when the market and everybody is just, you know, it's pretty much used to PS5 at that point, right? You're going to see everybody, like, you're going to see all the developers, like, push the box to the max and get the most out of the box. And then once they get all that, you know, all that good power out of it and push it, you know, and push the standard, then you're going to see it more likely near the end of the generation or getting closer to the end of the generation where you'll see this PS5 Pro system. But anyway, that's pretty much it in that regard. And I don't necessarily believe it's going to happen anytime soon. And as far as this being a counterattack to Microsoft, I mean, let's face it, both platforms are going to have one. The question is who will come out with theirs, I guess, first. And that is going to be a good question. But now that this has actually gotten a lot of traction, I do believe Microsoft more likely went right back to hardware mode, and they're both like are beating the clock as we speak to get these units out here, you know, at least in tip top shape when we eventually get there, okay? Now, without further ado, let's get into some quick news, and I'll end this video. It turns out that we are going to get a PS5 Special Edition, and this is going to be designed by Travis Scott, reportedly, and this is coming very, very soon for the PS5, so that's going to be pretty cool. I'm wondering what he's going to come up with in terms of designs for the PS5, but that'll be cool. For those of you wanting designs for your PS5, you guys remember that website we talked about where it was Customize My Plates, or actually, before it was Customize My Plates, it was called Plates Station 5. Well, they're now called Customize My Plates, and they sell skins for your PS5. So if you're interested, you can go ahead and go there and get yourself a skin for your PS5. Or you can wait for the custom shells, which are inevitably going to be sold by Sony for the PS5 in the future. So either way you want to go about it, really, you know. This right here is an interesting read right here. This was actually posted yesterday, so listen to this. PlayStation 5 fan lottery responsible for noisier consoles. Now, according to this, it turns out not all the PS5s are actually being created equally or entirely equally. Obviously, the processors and all that stuff is the same. However, the fans are a big concern. If you guys look at the pictures right here, the PS5 fan that we saw in the breakdown, that's the one we got right there, versus the ones that are actually being found in actual units. So it turns out Sony might have actually, again, have been actually rushing to get this console out here. So again, it kind of makes sense. But at the same time, that is the price you pay, quote unquote, for being a what, guys? An early adopter. And I already knew they were going to have this issue at one particular point where they had to rush these consoles out here as quick as possible to get them in our hands. And now things are getting even worse where, you know, scalpers are getting them. You have shipments being robbed. I mean, it's pretty ridiculous out here in this world when it comes to this box. But hey, you know how things are. But anyway, that's pretty much the video. Thank you guys so very, very much for watching. I know I've been away. I have literally taken that hiatus from this channel, but I needed time to breathe, so to speak. I've been on Demon's Souls, playing with the fellas, chilling with the fam, and hopefully you guys are doing well. Thank you guys for watching. If you wouldn't mind, hit that like button if you enjoyed the video. I do appreciate it, and subscribe if you are new. Until next time, this is Big Cloud Gaming. I will see you back here on this channel, and man, it is good to be back home. You guys be blessed. Y'all be easy. And y'all keep it gaming. I'm out of here. Deuces.